in this lesson, we will see the options that are included in Revit's menu. To see those options, I will click on the File menu that can be found on the top left of the window. With the new option, you can create a new project or a new family, as well as other things such as title blocks and annotation symbols. You can also open an existing file. If I hover the cursor over the Open option for a few seconds, the types of files I can open appear. As you can see, I can open a Revit project, a Revit family, or even an IFC file. A file with the IFC file extension is an Industry Foundation Classes file. Next, there are the Save and Save as options with which you can save our project. Save overwrites the existing file, while Save as creates a new file with changes. This means that you should use Save as the first time you save our project, or if you wish to save an already saved project under a different name. You can also save a file as a template, so you can use this template in future projects. In addition, you can save a selected family that is loaded in the current project, a group of objects, or even 2Ds to create a detailing library for later use in other projects. For example, if you adjust the dimensions of a door or make any other changes to its properties, you can save this door as a new family and load it into future projects. Under the Save As option, you can find the Export option with which you can export the Revit file into a different format. As you can see, you can export Revit files into CAD formats such as WG and DGN, as well as other formats such as DDUP, IFC, PDF, and so on. The Export option follows the Print option, which, as its name indicates, prints selected views or sheets. At the bottom, there is the Options button. Once I click this button, the Options window appears. From the general group of settings, you can set save reminders every 30 minutes, 1 hour, or 2 hours, or you can even select the No Reminders option. So no message will appear to remind you to save the progress of your work. At this point, I will go to the User Interface settings. In this group of settings, you can define which ribbon tabs will be visible, and you can also create your own keyboard shortcuts by clicking on the Customize button. You can even customize what the double click will do on certain occasions. To get a better understanding of what this means, I will click on the Double Click's Customize button to open the corresponding window. As you can see, if I double click on a family item, the editing mode will be activated. I will expand the dropdown to see what other options I am given. Notice that I can even select Do Nothing. So nothing will happen if I double-click on a family. Another possible option is to edit the family type by selecting Edit Type. Similarly, I can change the double-click action for the rest of the element types. At this point, I will close this window to return to the main options. This time, I will go to the color settings. As its name suggests, from the color settings, we can define the canvas colors for the application. Last but not least, I will go to the file location settings to show you something important. From this group, you can define where the different Revit files will be saved.